The storage bucket is public. That is not a mistake. That is a growth hacking funnel. Every year we get personal thank you letter from cloud provider for hitting Q1 revenue target. Their Q1 revenue target. Yes, let's talk about the cloud. Kubernetes gave us portability. We can now move the outage from AWS to GCP within minutes. Our cloud bills, they send it in scientific notation. Back in the days, you needed 2 of everything. Now you need 20. I always said power to the microservices. Now we have more programming languages than developers. I write all diagrams on paper, because everything looks good on paper. Hello world in the cloud involves 1 load balancer, 2 database, 3 web servers, and 2 different cloud geozones for the observability stack. Are you asking about service? Oh, mamma mia, this is a long, complicated I don't really understand how it works. Our coffee machine runs on the cloud. I know it does not work. I like to say until cloud bill arrives, liquidity is like Schrödinger's cat. We are now doing edge computing. We moved our server rack 20 meters closer to AWS in data center, even a less latency. Oh, that is SLA in the cloud, mean. Observability this, observability that. The app stores more data about uptime than data about the app. Log ingress costs more than whole service. You're underestimating my underestimation. Crash loop back off is feature discovery. When I see over 3 GB Docker, I know it is node modules. The cloud is elastic. We set alerts for 100% memory or killed. But AWS memory goes to 110%. Nothing is owned in cloud. Everything is shared, including noisy neighbors. When you cannot SSH to master, you are the slave. We are automated our DBAs with managed service. No, we are paying more, but less complaining. Role-based access control. Kubernetes saved us so much money. We can almost afford the team that runs it. Why this new Lambda can't assume IAM role? High availability is 99.99%. Other 0.001 is the keynote demo. What does core mean in Kubernetes? Nobody knows. Normal CPU go to 100%. Cloud CPU go to 110%. Different physics. My favorite AWS tool, rsync. I do optimization all the time. I mark 3 orphan ABS volumes and tag them as a research. My tagging game is immaculate. We wrote a Lambda function to shut down other idle Lambda functions. It is now the biggest cost center. Half the Grafana dashboards are services that don't exist anymore. Our roadmap is Gartner hype cycle. We also have the private cloud, yes, whatever private means. I have 35.5 years in the industry experience with on-prem and hybrid cloud, microservices, serverless, back to monolith, hyperscaler, back to single on-prem server running Perl script. We are thinking about going back on-prem. I will just finish the DevOps article I'm reading. It is an interview with all 7 customers of Azure. Oh, it is pager alert. We have team for this. No rush. It will take 2 minutes for VPN login anyway. It works more deterministic than MySQL on cloud. Nothing is normal in the cloud. Do you know how many ENIs per EC2 instance? Listen, nothing is standard in cloud. Try importing a MySQL local database to cloud database. You'll hire all team and fix cloud bugs for a cloud provider. Cloud was so expensive, I could write my own telemetry system. How do I estimate the cloud bill? This complicated mathematical function of using the... We're still liquid. I have whole degree in guesstimates. Cloudformation and Cognito are both AWS. The completely different usability. My tip for more performant cloud, ask for more replicas. We like to take the smartest minds of the generation and then have them VPN tunnel debugging. I know what I'm doing.